How do you draw a trend line on a stock chart? This video is about trend lines for beginners, and in this video, I'll be sharing with you three things. How do you identify a trend line? How to draw a trend line correctly? And how to draw trend lines on stock charts? If you are interested in that, this video is for you. Okay, let's begin. What are trend lines? The definition of a trend line is a straight line that connects two or more price points which extends to the future to act as a line of support and resistance. If you are not too sure of what support and resistance is, check out my video over here where I share with you what support and resistance is, how do you identify them, and how to use them in your trading and investing. In a nutshell, support and resistance are price floor and price ceiling respectively. When prices reach a price floor or a support level, in this case, prices tend to bounce back up. And when prices reach a price ceiling, or in this case, a resistance, prices tend to bounce back down. So that is what a support and resistance level is in a nutshell. The typical support and resistance are horizontal, but our trend lines are diagonal support and resistance. So what this means is that our trend lines are usually like that or like that. So trend lines are diagonal support and resistance levels. Okay, now that we know what trend lines are, let's dive right into the reason why you guys are on this video. How to draw trend lines. The first step we need to take in order to draw trend line is to first identify the trend of the market. If prices are on an uptrend, we will look to connect the higher lows that prices make. If prices are on a downtrend, we look to connect the lower highs that prices make. Let me give you a quick overview of how to identify the trend of the market. So the first trend that we're going to take a look at is an uptrend. So in an uptrend, prices tend to move something like that. So you'll move like in this wave-like direction, right? So this is how prices tend to move in an uptrend. The first way to identify an uptrend is to look at the general direction of how prices are moving. So if you take a look at this example here, the general direction that prices are moving is upwards, right? From here to here, prices are moving upwards. So we say that prices are on an uptrend. The second way to identify an uptrend is to look at whether prices are making higher lows and higher highs. So what do I mean by higher lows and higher highs? If you take a look here, from here to here, prices are making higher lows, right? Here is higher than here. And from here to here, prices are making higher highs, right? Because here is higher than here. And for here is higher than here. So this is a higher low. And for here is higher than here. So this is a higher high. And similarly, this one here is higher than here. So it's a higher low, right? So when prices are making higher lows and higher highs, we say that prices are on an uptrend. That is how we identify an uptrend. How do we identify a downtrend? When prices are in a downtrend, prices tend to move in this direction. So you move down. So you move something like that. The first way to identify a downtrend is to look at the general direction that prices are moving. So from here to here, we know that prices have declined generally over time. When prices decline generally over time, we say that prices are on a downtrend. So that's the first way to identify a downtrend. The second way to identify a downtrend is to take a look whether prices are making lower highs and lower lows. We take a look here and we compare it to here. Here is lower than here, right? So prices are making lower highs. So if we compare here to here, we say that prices are making lower lows, right? Because here is lower than here. So again, here is a lower high because here is lower than here. And similarly, here is a lower low because we are comparing here to here. So that is lower highs and lower lows. So if prices are making lower highs and lower lows, we say that prices are on a downtrend. So that is how we identify an uptrend and a downtrend. And that is the first step to drawing a trend line. So the first step to drawing a trend line is to first identify the trend of the market. After identifying the trend of the market, the second step would be to connect three or more price points. So what do I mean by connect three or more price points? So if prices are on an uptrend, we want to look to connect three or more higher lows. And if prices are on a downtrend, we look to connect three or more lower highs. Let's take a look at some examples. So if we take a look at this example, for this example, prices are on an uptrend. So how do we know that prices are on an uptrend? There are two steps to identifying the trend. So the first step is to look at the general direction that prices are moving towards, right? So from here to here, we see that prices have generally increased over time. That is a very general way of identifying that prices are on an uptrend. The second way to identify that prices are on an uptrend is to take a look whether prices are making higher lows and higher highs. So in this example, we see that from here to here, prices have made higher lows. And from here compared to here, prices have made higher highs. And again, if we compare this one to this one, prices have made higher lows. And we compare here to here, prices have made higher highs. So when prices have made higher lows and higher highs, we say that prices are on an uptrend. That is the first step to drawing a trend line, is to first identify the trend of the market. The second step after we have identified that prices are on an uptrend is to look to connect the higher lows. So in this example, we first want to identify the higher lows. So the first higher low is down here, the second higher low is here, and the third higher low is there. After we have identified three or more higher lows, we draw a line across and we get our trend line, right? So that is how we draw a trend line in an uptrend. Now let's take a look at the actual price chart and see how the trend line is drawn in an uptrend. So this is the price chart from Microsoft. How do we know that the stock is on an uptrend? The first way we take a look at is we compare whether prices are generally increasing over time. So from here to here, prices have generally increased over time. So that's the first way we identify the trend of the market. The second way to identify the trend of the market is to take a look whether prices are making higher lows and higher highs. So if we take a look here, from here compared to here, prices are making higher lows. And from here to here, prices are making higher highs. And similarly, if we compare here to here, prices are making higher lows. And again, from here to here, prices are making higher highs. When prices are making higher lows and higher highs, we say that the trend of the stock is on an uptrend. That's the first step. We identify the trend of the market. Then we look to connect three or more higher lows. So in this case, we identify the higher lows. So here are the higher lows, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and so on, right? So that is the higher lows. So after we have identified the higher lows, we plot a line across. So in this case, we plot the line across here and we have our trend line. That's how we draw a trend line for a stock that is on an uptrend. Now let's take a look at how to draw a trend line when a stock is on a downtrend. In this example, prices are on a downtrend. And how do we know that prices are on a downtrend? There are two ways, right? So the first way is to look at the general direction that prices are moving over time. So if we take a look here from left to right, here to here, prices are generally decreasing over time, right? So that is the first way to identify the trend of the market. The second way to identify a downtrend is to look whether prices are making lower highs and lower lows. If we take a look at this example here. Here, we compare to here, prices are making lower highs, right? Because here is lower than here. And if we compare here to here, we see that prices are making lower lows, right? Because here is lower than here. And again, if we take a look at here compared to this one, we say that prices are making lower highs, right? Because here is lower than here, right? So when prices are making lower highs and lower lows, we say that prices are on a downtrend. And after we have identified that prices are on a downtrend, the next thing we want to take a look at is to look to connect the lower highs. In this example, where are the lower highs? So the lower highs are here, here, and here, right? So there are three lower highs. Once we have identified three or more lower highs in a downtrend, we can draw a trend line across. And that is how we draw a trend line for a stock that is on a downtrend. Okay, let's take a look at an example on the price chart. So for this stock, the first step is to identify the trend of the market. By now, you probably have enough practice to determine that this stock is on a downtrend. The next thing that we want to do is to look to connect three or more lower highs. So in this case, the lower highs are this point here, here, and here, and here, right? So we draw a line across. And that is how we draw a trend line for a stock that is on a downtrend. Now that we have went through some examples of how to draw a trend line in an uptrend and in a downtrend, let's take a look at how we can actually draw them on our price chart. Okay, so let's jump onto my charting platform. The charting platform that I'm using is Thinkorswim. I'm going to show you how I draw trend lines on Thinkorswim. This is the stock chart for the SPY or the S&P 500. Taking a look at the SPY chart, I can identify an area where we can draw our trend line. So this area is here. So I'm going to zoom in here. For this area, we know that prices are on an uptrend because from here, from the left to the right, we see that prices are generally increasing over time. And the second way to identify that prices are on an uptrend is to look at whether prices are making higher lows and higher highs. So if we take a look at this example here, here from here, and we compare it to here, we see that prices are making higher lows, right? Because here is higher than here. And if we take a look at here compared to here, prices are making higher highs because here is higher than here. So we know that prices are on an uptrend. Now that we know that prices are on an uptrend, the next thing that we're going to take a look at is to identify the higher lows. So the higher lows would be points like this, here, and here, right? So now that we have identified the higher lows, the last step is to draw a trend line connecting these higher lows together. To plot a trend line on the stock chart for Think or Swim, I click the button here and I select this one. So if you see this one, this indicate to us trend line. So I click on this one and I start the trend line from here and I put it all the way across connecting the higher lows, right? So if I do it here and I draw it like that, this is one of the higher lows. This is the second higher low. This is the third higher low, and this is the fourth higher low. That is how we draw a trend line for a stock that is on an uptrend. Now let's take a look at an example where we can draw a trend line for a downtrend. For the SPY, let's go back to the Great Recession period where the SPY is on a downtrend. So that is in 2008, right? So we go all the way back to 2008. Okay. So you can see that here prices are on a downtrend. Okay, so for this time area, I already identified the trend line. So I'm going to zoom in on the prices first. So I'm going to zoom in here. For this one, we identify that the stock is on a downtrend, right? Because generally prices are decreasing over time from here to here, right? And that's the first way. The second way is to see that prices are making lower highs and lower lows. So how do we do that? We take a look at from here, we compare it to here, right? So it's a lower high, right? Because here is lower than here. And we compare it here and here, we see that prices are making lower lows, right? Because here is lower than here. We have identified that the trend is on a downtrend. The next thing that we want to do is to look to connect the lower highs for this stock. We'll connect here all the way to here. The lower highs are here, 1, 2, and 3, right? And this is the fourth one. That is how we draw a trend line for a stock that is on a downtrend. Let's take a look at one more example. So let's take a look at Apple. So Apple is AAPL. Okay, so for this one, I also see a place where we can draw a trend line from this point here to this point here. Prices are on an uptrend, right? Because here is higher than here, right? So generally, prices are increasing over time. And the second way to determine that prices are on an uptrend is to look whether prices are making higher lows and higher highs. So if we take a look right here, we see that from here to here, prices are making higher lows, right? Because here is higher than here, and here is higher than here. So prices are making higher highs. And similarly, here is higher than here. So prices are making higher lows. And again, here is higher than here. So it's higher highs and higher lows, right? So once we have identified that prices are making higher highs and higher lows, we say that prices are on an uptrend. After we have determined that the stock is on an uptrend, the second step is to connect the higher lows of the stock. We again click on the button here and select the trend line tool, and we plot our trend line. So how do we plot our trend line? We first plot it here and we connect all the higher lows. This is the first higher low. This is the second higher low. This is the third higher low. This is the fourth higher low. This is the fifth higher low, and so on. That is how we draw a trend line for a stock that is on an uptrend. In this video, you have learned how to identify a trend line, how to draw a trend line correctly, and how to draw trend lines on stock charts. If you have learned something from this video, smash that like button because it will help the channel grow and reach more people and help them learn more about investing, trading, and the stock market. And if you have liked this video, make sure you subscribe to this channel because next week I'll release the second part of this video where I share with you my trendline trading strategy and how I use trendline to generate double-digit returns in the stock market. I'll see you in that video. To your financial success.